Welcome, Cancer, to your reading. I'm Scorpio Moon. Intuition bring messages from Spirit. This reading is general and it may or may not resonate with you. Take what resonates and leave the rest. And if you'd like to book a personal reading with me, you can visit www.scorpiomoonintuition.com. This reading is for Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus. Crosswatcher, if you're the ones watching this, then it may resonate with you. So let's begin. If you're wearing headphones, please lower the volume. I welcome in my spirit guides and holy angels, nice and greatest good. I welcome messages of love and light that bring healing and love to you all. Please bless this reading. Thank you. All right, Cancer, let's go ahead and take a look and see what is coming towards you in the month of September in love. Spirit, please bring forth clear messages in regard to the person connected to Cancers in love. What does Cancer need to know about their love and trust in the month of September? What is coming towards Cancer in love in the month of September? Thank you, Spirit. Three messages in regards to the person connected to Cancer in love. All right. So we have people pleasing, it's kind of neutral. We also have sad and depressed, winter, coldness, isolation, and forgiveness that came up in reverse. So what I'm getting is this, that they're slowly changing their vibration to open up. And I really feel that they have matured in a sense where they may ask you for their forgiveness. They may come to you and say that they didn't realize that they were seeking validation from other people. Maybe there's a realization or revelation about your person, about how they acted, and they want to know, would you forgive them? Okay, I'm hearing like an I'm sorry. Now, I can't remember if I channeled that kind of message before for you in the past. It sounds familiar, but I keep getting I'm sorry from this particular person. They don't want to be sad anymore, okay? I really feel like your person was always trying to, you know, be like a center of attention. Maybe they were looking for, you know, just feeling like they were worthy in front of like groups of people, friends, family. And you feel like, you know, where do you fit in this person's reality, right? Because you seem to not matter to this person. Okay, they were doing their own thing. That's what I'm getting. So let's go ahead and clarify. Spirit, can you please bring forth clear messages in regards to this person that is connected to Cancer in love? What does Cancer need to know about their love and trust? Thank you. Please clarify forgiveness. Why is forgiveness here? Why is forgiveness here? So they have fear that they were going to be stuck. They don't know if you ever forgive them. Maybe they're stuck in their ways or stuck in whatever situation that they're in. Spirit, please clarify. Yeah, and I also see her return and it's in reverse. They don't know if they can come back after what they have done. Okay. Spirit, why is winter coldness isolation here? Please clarify. This coldness and isolation. they recognize that they were really cold towards you in the past, and now they're starting to open up. Why is sad and depression here? Yeah, again, they want to know, would you forgive them? So this whole energy in the month of September is that there is a person that may return back to you, Cancer, and the whole thing about them is about forgiveness. Would you forgive them? You know, I really feel like they went off their own path, you know, and they kind of blew you over, like you didn't matter, and they were just worried about other people, places, and situations. Like they had places to go, people to see, and you were kind of excluded. And I really feel like you possibly were trying to contact them or have some level of communication, but they wouldn't return your phone call. You know, maybe they waited till the next day for some, okay, where this person's like, hey, I'm sorry, you know, something came up, or you know, they got invited to like a friend's house or something like that, right? That's what I feel. Okay, they just were not awakened that, you know, they were like, you know, dropping everything on a you know, dropping everything for the sake of pleasing other people. Is there any final messages that want to come through about this person's spirit? Yeah, that's why there's separation. They want to know, would you forgive them for being in separation from them? And Cancer, okay, I already know. You're like, no, I'm not going to forgive them. Because I have a feeling like you're not going to forget what they've done towards you. Okay, so let's go ahead and see. You know, the other thing I'm also getting is like somebody here, you know, their car broke down on the side of the road and, you know, the cell phone wasn't working. And you were kind of wondering, you know, are they okay? They're afraid to tell you maybe whoever came and picked them up. You know what I mean? Maybe they were with someone at the time and you had no idea. So I really feel like your person was completely honest with you. Like, I really feel very strongly that there was another situation that they were dealing with. And honestly, they don't feel like a person who is secure, grounded within themselves. Like, this person is not spiritually awakened. Okay? They're really, I want to say superficial. Okay? They only care about what people think, you know, like they're like a crowd pleaser, things like that. Let's see. So for some, maybe you're dealing with a Leo and they're just gathering up the strength to make a decision. Okay, they're trying to figure out, you know, should they come to you? Okay, for some, you're dealing with the Capricorn. But what I'm feeling is that, you know, they're in two minds about a situation. Honestly, I really feel like there's another person here. And the other person, okay, they have the free will or the liberty to partake in, you know, extracurricular activities. This is drinking, partying up, you know, doing some naughty stuff. Like maybe they're into group sex and stuff. You know what I mean? Like stuff like that, guys. Okay, I know that's not going to be for everyone, but I am picking that up. They're not happy, okay? The reason why they're entertaining that kind of energy is because deep down inside, they're not really happy. They're not, again, they're not feeling secure. Now, I really feel like they're not secure in their family relationships. And that's another reason why, like, this is their outlet for them to just, you know, kind of do their thing, because they're kind of internally hurt deep down inside to be, you know, doing these kind of activities. And I see that they're really defensive. Now, in the very beginning, when I was channeling this, I saw like a chocolate male. He had curly hair, very similar to this. I just didn't say it because I know that's going to be specific to someone. And he was kind of muscular in nature. Okay. Very thin build from what I can see. And you know, the curly hair wasn't as frowed out as this gentleman's hair is, but he definitely had curly hair. Okay, and that must be for someone, because I'm seeing again, and this is a visual. So yeah, whoever this person is, they're really defensive. They're always like trying to protect themselves, or you know, kind of tell you like, well, I was at such and such, you know, why are you coming at me like that, you know? And they're kind of questioning you like, why are you tripping? Okay. I mean, that is somewhat specific for someone, but I feel like I have to say it. Now, I see that, you know, they had to make a decision and they're just stressed. Okay, this is the fear. They were kind of stuck in whatever situation they're in. Now, this could have been rectified if they came through with their truth. So let's say the truth might look a little suspect, right? Like, let's say that, yeah, my car broke down and this girl was with me. You know, what are they going to say about that, right? Yeah, they're going to have the talk. Now, I see that whatever the situationship was, okay, there was some sort of third party. They're trying to figure out how to communicate their truth. And I see that they really want to work on this connection with you, okay? Maybe you guys haven't been on the best terms, but I really feel like, yeah, if it's been maybe a period of 2 months, you could be dealing with the Gemini. Again, could be a Leo. Okay, we're getting out of Leo season, going into Virgo season. For some, you know, someone here is in a same-sex partnership. You know, I really feel like someone here has a same-sex partnership, but also they have a monogamous, like a heterosexual relationship with someone else. Like they go both ways. Okay, that's what I'm seeing, and I know that's not for everyone, but I have to pull it out because I'm picking up on it very strongly today. Now, this person really feels like you are a part of their destiny. They're just keeping a lot to themselves, and I just feel like they don't know what to do. Okay, so your person's gonna come back. They're gonna apologize, okay, that they're just trying to please people. I really feel like this is a secret relationship, and it may be you, Cancer, that you're in a same-sex partnership with this particular person, and then your person is having a heterosexual relationship with someone else, okay? I don't know. Take it as it resonates. It's not for everyone, but I see that. Now, I see that they're just waiting for the right time, okay? You could be dealing with the fire sign, could be a Taurus. They're really looking at their higher self, and that's why they're just choosing to hold back. So there's someone who wants return, but they're afraid to communicate to you. They're afraid. I feel like you've been in a little period of separation with a particular person for about 2 months, and that's for some. And they don't know if you'll ever forgive them. That's what I'm seeing. Yeah, they really feel like things are not stable with them, but they're willing to come forward to you because they're not feeling very good. Yeah, there was some third party interference between the two of you, and they had to let go of like a traditional thing that they were holding on to. This could be family, or maybe their family situation isn't doing so well, so they decided to leave it to come to you. Okay, because you really ultimately make this person happy. And if there were some other relationship or situation that they're in, that person really had expectations out of the situation, and they were kind of manipulative, and that's why this person didn't know. I honestly feel like your person felt that you wouldn't really understand what they were going through. Like maybe you wouldn't believe them, but whoever their karmic person was, they kind of manipulated them, made them feel guilty, you know, and so that was like a part of the reason why they stayed in that situation. But this person loves you, okay? So Cancer, don't take it too hard just because, you know, you haven't heard from them and they showed their true colors at some point. You know, practice forgiveness. And I'm not telling you what to do, obviously, but you know, if you feel connected to this one and you're having a hard time of forgiving, this person really wants forgiveness. You know, I'm not going to say that they're not going to do it again, but as far as I can see so far, this person is genuinely in love with you. Okay. They're just stuck in some sort of karmic relationship that they felt obligated to be in. Okay. For whatever reason, They don't know. They're a little confused themselves. Like, they don't have all the answers also. But I do know this. They have genuine love and affection to you, okay, or towards you. They're trying to free themselves. They're trying to, you know, be single. I really feel like for some, okay, if you're like a female-female relationship, okay, they're trying to let go of a karmic situation because they're codependent on a masculine energy, you know, to help support them in some sort of way. And that's the reason for them stuck. But I really feel like there's like this relationship with a particular other individual, okay, with you, Cancer. I feel like it's a same-sex relationship, okay? Again, that's not going to resonate for everyone, but it's coming strong today, okay? I just feel I have to speak of that. Yeah, this person definitely loves you a lot. And they want to balance things out. So they want to become more independent. They want to be self-sufficient. They also want to be in a situationship with you where both you guys are kind of like co-creating with one another. Okay, that's the vibe that I'm getting. So let's see what else. Now, they want to tell you the truth that they really want to make an offer to you, okay? They know they're slow, but they're coming, okay? Now, you've been really thinking, is this person really coming? How do they feel? They really feel that you're very beautiful, very handsome, okay? They know that this isn't over. And you're kind of, like, upset. You're trying to heal that your person actually chose someone else over you. But I'm going to tell you this. This person really is into you. They're attracted to you. They adore you. And they will be back. Okay? Right now, they don't know if you would take them back. You know, but they really want to come in quickly. Okay? So for you, you're blocked up in your heart because you don't want to hurt yourself or you don't want to get hurt again by this particular person. But you're feeling the same too. Like you're having the hots for this one, but you guys want to get it together. Now, in the outcome, there's something shocking here. And I see here in Aries energy, I really feel that there's a level of dominance, okay? They're surprised that they're actually in control over their situation. So maybe finally they actually man up, okay, if you will, or woman up, whatever. But I really feel like now they're more stable, more secure. They feel more independent. They're not codependent on another situation. And you are inspired. You're feeling like, wow, like, here is your person. I feel like it's a divine masculine if you're watching this as a twin flame connection. And the person who is watching is divine feminine. But take it as it resonates, okay? It's not gender specific. But that's what I'm saying. I mean, I really feel like this kind of turned you on. And you're like, well, bring it on, baby. Yeah, there's going to be an apology. They just didn't want to fight. They didn't want any gossip or drama also. And I see that you keep thinking about the past and you kind of know this. So I really feel this is a very, this is actually really good news. So if you've been in separation from a person, this person is coming back. They're coming back stronger than ever before. Okay. And you're going to see someone actually put in some effort to come back. Okay, you guys are in separation now. They used to be a people pleaser, but they've changed. Okay, you know, they had a hard time of letting go and setting boundaries. You know, but now, okay, so maybe it was because of their finances and career. That's why I really feel strongly that one of the reasons why they stayed stuck in that situation with the karmic was because of money. But now that they're getting on their own two feet and they're becoming more sovereign and independent, things are changing. So this is actually really good news. So let's see what else. Spirit, what does your person want to say? Wow. They want to say a lot. Okay. I looked you up online to see what you've been up to, see? I've been checking you out. Your words linger in my mind. Being apart has been life-changing for me. My mind and heart always comes back to you. And your intensity frightens and allures me all at the same time. I really feel like, you know, you guys are like kind of different, but it's like an attraction. And you guys, like, it's like something you never felt before. It's like sparks, you know, it's It's different, but it's nice. You know what I mean? It's like that kind of an energy. So let's see what else. What else does your person want to say? Your person is very talkative today. I see a little part of you in everyone I meet. I'm still haunted by my actions, so they know what they did to you. They apologize. Look, karma's a bitch. I finally got mine, and I was reminded of your scent recently. Wow. So you must have smelled a certain way to this person. They're actually remembering you. Okay, so let's see. Spirit, please reveal to me, what is it? What is the guidance that you have for Cancer at this time? Guidance messages, please, Spirit. What is the guidance? Dang. Wow, look at this. Surrender to effortlessness. Stop pushing so hard. The art of living means going with the flow instead of forcing a river. I really feel like this is more so for your person, but it could apply to you. Okay, especially this trapeze. This is my favorite card out of the whole deck. Obviously, she is swinging on this and feeling free, right? Like, you know, in her birthday suit. And what I'm really getting is that this person was too rigid. Maybe, you know, they're just all for like a traditional belief that is slowly dissipating. Maybe they're no longer believing in that narrative and they're changing. Like, I feel like this is soul growth. This is like an evolution of your person. They're starting to change. They're starting to be more independent and not be so rigid. And that's what I'm saying. So, I mean, and also with you, Cancer, if you're feeling like, you know, you're closed up and, you know, you don't want to budge, you know, let go. Okay. Don't be so crabby. It'll be all right. You know, things are going to be okay. Don't push too hard. Okay. Go with the flow. There's a particular person that it was in your past. And I really feel very strongly they're going to be returning. Okay. And it feels very positive. And if you want me to dive deeper into your situation, if you feel that, you know, this is your situation, you can definitely book a reading with me. And I can go deeper into your connection. If you have any specific questions that you want to ask, you can book the question reading. If you want an actual reading per se, I have many different readings that you can choose from. I also have a karmic reading if you feel that, you know, there's a karmic that is still in the way and you want, you know, some kind of information from spirit, like, are they still together? You know, are they finally moving on? Things like that. Then now is a good time to book. I have a sale that's going on. It's my summer sale that's been going on all summer long. It is going to finally end on September 1st. And so if you want to book a reading, now is a good time to do so. Also, we have a new moon in Virgo this weekend. This is a perfect time to detox and cleanse your energy, your auric field. And you can purchase bath salts, bath bombs, body scrubs, especially if you used to shower and you don't take a bath, then the body polish is the way to go. And you can find those products over on smibeautyandbath.com. All of the links are in the description box below. You can also find those same products on Etsy, which is etsy.com/shop/scorpiomoonintuition. Thank you all for watching. I really hope it was helpful, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.